This is my life?
That's right, Janet.
There must be some mistake.
This is your shining hour.
You just don't get it, do you? I don't want to take a stroll down memory lane, especially in front of a live studio audience. My life, up until this point, has been one of God's greatest practical jokes.
But let us in on the laugh. You're getting sprung from prison. I think the folks out there want to know all about that crooked path that led you there. How about it, folks? Do that before we should. Let's turn the clock back, shall we? A sleepy little town in Canada awakes one morning to the sound of a baby's cry. Little Janet makes her way into the world kicking and screaming. Her father deserts her at a young age, so she's raised with her elder sister Natalie by the long-suffering Wilma Marlowe.
She always liked Natalie best.
We can see why. There they are, folks, the Marlowe sisters.
I hated cameras. Natty was always picture perfect. Me, I always felt like someone tried to mold me out of vanilla pudding or something.
And we didn't get any better with age, did we?
Even in second grade, Janet was as homely as a mud fence.
Who is that?
Take a look.
If I live to be 100, I'll never forget little Janet Marlowe. Body could almost feel sorry for her if she hadn't been so sullen and disagreeable. I remember the Christmas pageant.
Recognize her?
That's my second grade teacher, Mrs. Snodgrass.
Elvira Snodgrass, come on down.
Don't slouch now. Sit up straight.
Now, Elvira.
Yes?
You mentioned something about the Christmas pageant.
Oh, the pageant that almost wasn't if Miss High and Mighty'd had her way. Talk about casting against type. She wanted to play the Virgin Mary.
Oh, no!
Of course, it was out of the question. The Blessed Virgin has to be played by someone with poise and grace. Natalie was born for the role.
A professional virgin.
So Janet was out of the play?
Oh, no, heavens no. Her voice had a low register, so I cast her as a shepherd. Covered her face with a crepe paper beard. Oh, Natalie was just wonderful as Mary. But Janet refused to wear her glasses, tripped over the creche, and literally brought the house down. Janet and Natalie, different as night from day. Proof that the Lord works in mysterious ways.
Johnny, isn't it time to bring on the next guest?
Still, I never dreamt that that pageant would come back to haunt Natalie after all these years. Janet never forgave nor forgot being pushed aside. There wasn't a grudge too small for her to hold. She put her sister down.
But I think we're getting ahead of ourselves. Thank you, Elvira Snodgrass.
Hope the new face takes, dearie. Can't be any worse than the old one.
Janet grew up lonely and embittered. Dating was not an option. She parlayed her gifts for mathematics into a low-paying, dead-end job as an accountant. Eventually, she managed to snag a husband. He cheated on her at their reception and on their honeymoon. The marriage ended in divorce. So once again, Janet found herself with no one to turn to, nowhere to go.
She just materialized one day on our doorstep. Things were finally starting to look up for my Uncle Porkchop and his doll, until Janet blew into town.
That's Haley!
Haley, I understand that when Janet came to Pine Valley, it caused a lot of turmoil.
Oh, did it ever. Do we have time before we go to commercial?
Grab your snacks and get comfortable. Do I have a story for you?
Gotta go back to the office.
Yeah, we'll tell Jamal we said hey.
We'll do that.
I guess he's pretty excited about spring break and everything, huh?
Well, he's taking kind of a working vacation.
He's doing some odd jobs for Alec McIntyre.
Yeah, I saw him without Alec the other day.
Alec McIntyre doesn't seem to be the kind of guy that's going to take a strange kid under his wing, though.
Jamal told me it was something about it being a punishment.
Well, in my line, it's called quid pro quo.
Jamal took Alec's watch, so I made him return it and pay back with interest. So he's doing some odd jobs and errands at lunchtime and after school.
You do the crime, you do the time. Kids got to learn early. Actions have consequences. I think it's a great idea.
I think it's anything but. Jamal shouldn't be anywhere near Alec McIntyre.
How are we coming on the proxy request?
We? What we? I ran out of spit 50 envelopes ago. Enchantment makes lipstick and junk. If I was to vote who should run the place, it'd be Erica King.
Oh, well, thank you for the vote of confidence.
And I saw her in court. She's a knockout. Smart, too.
Yeah, well, how is she going to run the company from prison? Hmm? Maybe she'll do an infomercial from her cell at Plattsville.
Livia's sharp. She'll get her off.
Less chatter, more work.
I'm fresh out of those proxy deals.
Top left-hand drawer.
Ooh-wee. Talk about knockouts. How'd a guy like you get hooked up with this hot number?
Hey, get your hands off that.
You okay?
Fine.
Yeah, I can tell. You know, if you want to cry, it's okay. People cry at weddings. It happens all the time.
Well, yours is next. I can't wait for that.
Neither can I. I guess Dixie and I are just going to have to keep doing it till we get it right.
I must say I'm surprised to see you here, Angelique. Happily, but surprised nonetheless.
Well, I would have come from the ends of the earth to be at Edmund's wedding.
I feel exactly the same way, despite what might have been.
It would mean the world to him to have you here.